So you're wondering how to install WordPress on my computer. Well, in this video, I'll show you how to install WordPress locally on your Mac or Windows. And it's totally free.
It's free.
It's free.
It's free.
It's free real estate.
Tips with Punch.
Hello, internet people. My name is Robert and I'm your website guy. If you're looking to learn more about how to improve your website, get more traffic, and just in general website related stuff, this is the right channel for you. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. Let's get started by downloading a software on your computer that will run WordPress. Just head to Google and search for Localwp. So head to localwp.com. I'll leave a direct link in the video description and you will land on a website like this. So next you need to download the software onto your computer. We need it because WordPress runs on a coding language called PHP, and for the database it uses MySQL. So you need both of those to host a WordPress locally. That's what this tool will do for you.
Enough talk!
So just click on the download button, then select if you're on Mac or Windows. I'm on Windows, so I'll select that one. Then just add your first name, last name, and email address. Right now, the phone number is not required, so I'm gonna skip that one. And then click on Get It Now button. And it should start downloading the software now. If it doesn't, just click on this link here, then just save the file on your computer. This will take a few minutes depending on your internet speeds. So before you start doing this, just wait, it will only take a few minutes. But just keep in mind, only you can see this website on your computer. To make it publicly accessible, you will need to buy a domain and a web hosting. I'll add a video here at the top that shows you how to set up a public website from scratch using my favorite hosting provider. Once the download is ready, just open the file that you just installed. I'll do it directly from my browser like this. If you have multiple users on your computer, then you will need to choose if you want to install LocalWP for your user only or for everybody. Click next and choose the location where you want to install LocalWP. I'll just keep the default folder. Now, the installation will take a few minutes. You can pause the video until it's done.
Loading.
Once the download is done, make sure you have selected Run Local and click on Finish. LocalWP should open up now. You will see that you need to read through the terms and conditions, and if you agree with them, just tick this checkbox and click on the I agree button. So here you can see an introduction to this tool and some of the features it has. You can check them out, but I'm just gonna click on the close button here in the top right corner. Hey, if you liked the video so far, please consider hitting the like button. That would help me a lot with the YouTube algorithm. Great, now you have LocalWP installed. Let's just set it up so that you can start playing around with WordPress. Okay, awesome. Now we get to the fun part, as we are going to create a WordPress website right here. Just click on the Create a New Site button. It will ask for your site's name. Just add whatever you want. It really doesn't matter. It's only for you. So I'm going to call mine punchsalad.com. And if you click on the advanced options, you can see that the local site domain will be this one. So that's the URL. So let me just remove the .com part from my site name. It will just confuse me later. A bit like Arnie's English in the early days.
I understand. It is not pleasant to lose money once one becomes accustomed to its use.
Actually, those are the wisest words I ever heard him saying. After this movie, he started talking like this.
But I'm old woman.
The other settings you can keep as is and just click on continue. In this screen, you can choose if you want LocalWP to use default settings for your WordPress environment or if you want to use something custom. The custom has few options to choose from, like the PHP version, web server, and database. But honestly, I would just go with the preferred option unless you know what you're doing. So I'm going to select the preferred, then click on continue again. Now, you need to create a WordPress user login. Since this is only for you, you don't need to worry about security and you can keep the username and password pretty simple. And you can also change the admin email if you want to, just right here. And the last dropdown is to choose if you want to have a multi-site WordPress installation. But for this tutorial, I'll choose no, since most people don't have multi-site. Okay, now Localwp will install and set everything up. Here is what it is actually doing. WordPress work. Once you see this screen, it means everything is ready. And you can click on the view site here on the right. It will open up a new tab in your browser and you'll see this default WordPress website. You can see that the URL is now punchsalad.local. This just means that this is installed on your computer and you can now access it with this URL. Just keep in mind that you need to have Localwp running in the background and that you have started this site. You see here at the top, stop this site, and here on the left you see that it has this green circle. It means this site is running. If it's not, you'll be able to just start the site here in the top right corner. You can try to click on this trust link. It should add a local SSL certificate, but for me it didn't work. I think there is some kind of a bug with the software, so I hope they will fix it soon. Okay, let's take a look at the WordPress admin dashboard. You can just click on this admin button here on the right. It will open up a new browser tab and you can now log into WordPress with the credentials you created a few minutes ago. Arnie, what's your password?
Crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and they hear the lamentation of their women.
If you already have a website, then check out the YouTube card right here, where I show you how to copy your live site to your local host. This is WordPress dashboard where you can now do anything you want. For example, let's say you want the website to look different. You can just go to Appearance, then click on the Add New button. And in the search box, you can search for any theme in the WordPress library. For example, Astra or any other theme that you like. I like Astra, so you can try it out first. So once you're happy with your website on your computer, you will probably want to make it publicly available. For that, you will need to have a domain name and a web hosting. If you already have a web host, in the first video right here, I will show you how you can move your website from your computer to a web host. And you want to use the same web host as I'm using, then there should be another video right here where I show you how to sign up with my favorite hosting provider and set up WordPress.